last stage, the policeman or the prosecutor asks you, is there any more things that you want to say?
Okay.
Like to say, or you should not?
Oh, yes, yes.
There is temptation.
Yes. In my old experiences, men usually end up as sex offenders by lovely statements. Mm-hmm. What they want to say, that what they recall in the moment, temporarily, spontaneously, it is a very, very dangerous thing.
Nice.
Are you ready to state your testimony in front of your investigator? Your style and your style of statement will be ready enough? Is it good enough?
I see.
This is very important.
Coming to the police station or prosecutors, whoever, and then presenting yourselves and then presenting your statement,
yes.
You have to be ready, both sides. You have to get ready to present yourself, and also your statement has to be ready without any flaw, right?
Well, yes, right. You need to prepare, and a good expression, I think. Mm-hmm. You need to prepare well mentally.
I see.
And well physically. Well expression. It's a very important day. And you are, please remember, remember that you are not there to say what you want. The police station is the place what you should to say about your case. It's not the place what you want to say.
I see.
It's a very important thing. You need to remember. You should remember. You must not forget about that.
Oh, I see. Mm. So you're not there to say things you want to say or explain, but not. You have to only say things that you should say.
Yes, right. Your statement against you make you go to jail. So you need to prepare and you need to follow your attorney's plan. And you need to say what should you say. It is very important, the last thing.
Oh, I see. Because people get tempted to say things more, because normally, I mean, from my experience, interpretation,
yes.
at the very last stage, the policeman or the prosecutor asks you, is there any more things that you want to say?
Okay.
Like to say, or you should not?
Oh, yes, yes.
There is temptation.
Yes. In my old experiences, men usually end up as sex offenders by lovely statements. What they want to say, that what they recall in the moment, temporarily, spontaneously, it is a very, very dangerous thing.
I see.
You need to think about how you will win the statement of your opponent, the accuser.
I see. So, like we said, this is kind of world plan and playing out according to the world plan. And you have to present yourself and the statement, but you have to be ready inside and out, from top to bottom. And then strategy and plan, those two are very important with your lawyer.
Okay, you're right.
See. So, about lastly, presenting oneself to the prosecutor's office or police station.
Yes.
Is there any important tip that they have to remember?
You need to dress up. You need to dress very good. Because the policeman and investigator, they are human. So they see your appearance and they
today?
See your face. Your style. They have some prejudice about the criminals. So you don't have to make you seem to criminals.
So you don't want to look like criminal.
You are innocent people, innocent person. You look like innocent person to your investigator. So you need to dress up.
Dress up, then down.
And borrow some good clothes and makeup.
Oh, I see.
Your face and a smile.
Smile.
And think you are the innocent person.
I see.
In the moment.
So like, I mean, I happen to think of that gentleman like him shows up for to make statement. Nobody would think that he did such a thing. And then, of course, you must be innocent. So dress up, then dress down, and then dress charmingly. That
That's
is
right.
also important because all the investigators and whatnot, they are all human. So it is also important. So if somebody like this gentleman shows up to make statement, nobody would think that that person committed such a crime. So how you look, how you present yourself is very important. So don't take it casual. So dress up, then dress down, and then make your best to present yourself.
Yes, right.
That is helpful and critical.